Recently, Kelsey and I have done a couple videos watching a game show called Moment of Truth, which ran, it's an old game show and it ran for 2 seasons because it's the most effed up show I've ever seen in my entire life. And it's unreal. If you haven't watched those videos, go watch them. But today, we're not going to watch an episode of it. Instead, we're
enemies post an Instagram of them like making out in the club afterwards. So I'm like,
Goldie, the host,
my daughter,
show?
Is the one who's like, "Dad, you have got to chill." Right? This happens. Like, it's all so deep to me, right? I really don't want to ask the questions. And it's the only time I've done a game show where I literally say to them, "Don't make me read the next question."
I know.
I'm okay with it. I'm like, but I have to say it out loud. Yeah. Those words, I'm going to form them in my mouth and they're going to come out. And then afterwards, I'm like, oh God, this is horrible. And they are like, hey, let's get a picture together. And it's Lauren from your first episode, the blonde, and her husband, and the homewrecker. And it's like,
There's a picture of you all together?
They took a picture of me backstage. This is pre-Insta. And I'm literally just crawling out of my skin. I feel like I've ruined Western civilization.
That's
and they're
weird.
Like, yeah, that was rad.
How were they not like fist fighting each other? That's what I
Because was you asked me if it's real and I don't know.
Wow.
I just don't fucking know, man. I didn't want to do the show at all.
Yeah.
So when I tell you how I got the show, if you're interested in that
I would love to. That was my next question. How did you get it?
So I was doing Antiques Roadshow.
Okay.
Equally as crazy a show.
yeah.
Because I have range.
Well, you know what? Well, I would assume that it's better to host as a note. And let's say it was all fake. I would assume that the producer was smart enough to not let him know so that he doesn't have to fake stuff because it's way harder to fake it than do it naturally.
I do. So I get hired to do this lame-ass pilot for this game show, and I'm doing my best to help, and we shoot all day long. It's like 9:30 on a Friday, and we finally wrap, and I'm exhausted.
That she'd rather be with someone else, but I think we still have a shot at this. I'm going to get my funky pops, so talk later.
And a little bitter. I'm like, I'm just going home. I'm not going out for beer. I've got my suit on. I got my makeup on. I'm all hosted out, and I'm just going to drive home this way. And as I'm walking to my car, an old buddy of mine calls me, who's a producer, and says, hey, we're shooting this pilot for this show. And we're having a hard time. They just fired the host. And this was for NBC at the time. And they said, NBC wants you.
They fired the host. I think the host probably might have quit.
I know who it is, and I'll tell you who it is, and you're more accurate. He says, where are you? I said, well, I'm at Hollywood Center, and they were at Sunset Gower. It's like 5 minutes away. I said, you know, are you in trouble? He said, yeah. I said, well, I'll help you. He said, but one thing, the producer is this guy who I'd had a falling out with. Like, he had, in my opinion, screwed me out of what turned out to be millions of dollars.
Oh, geez.
And we hadn't spoken for 10 years, right? Okay.
Oh, no.
And I said to my buddy Mike, I'm like, dude, I don't have time for grudges. If this helps
Who was the initial?
You know, bygones are bygones.
The initial host?
So I literally drive around the block in my car. It's 10 o'clock at night on a Friday. I scoot down in my car as I watch the other host walk to his car, who is managed by me, my manager. So my manager is walking in the car, not knowing I'm the one replacing him, right?
Oh, my God.
And Mike jumps in my car and starts explaining the show to me. And I'm like, yeah, whatever. I'm not even listening. Because I'm worried about seeing this producer that I haven't talked to.
Right.
So I'm literally walking from my car to the studio. I take my tie off and hand it to the producer. A PA brings me a cup of coffee. Just really Hollywooded out on this one, right? I'm feeling myself gangster level.
This is interesting, though.
I walk in, I see this producer, he goes, hey, and I'm like, no. And when I think of it now, it's just so stupid.
There probably isn't much of that.
But I'm like a badass, quote him a figure and say, you know, no contract, this figure, my desk, Monday. And I think back, I'm like, what the, who are you? And he said, okay.
That's badass, by the way.
It is.
So I kind of laugh and I'm like, it's kind of weird that on a Friday night, I'm like in makeup and a suit ready to host like an EMT waiting for a call.
Yeah.
I'm working the West Side and like Game Show Network's Todd Newton has the East Side.
Yeah, people don't know. That's what working in TV is like.
Yeah.
You got to be in full makeup at all times.
I'm sipping. I'm watching the whole thing.
Just waiting. Yeah.
So anyway, I shake hands with my nemesis. I walk in the set. The producer's like this, the stage manager's like this, and I go into just survival mode. I'm like, everybody.
Yeah, it's just kind of boring. Not because it's boring. It's interesting, but guys, we get it though. He's the host of the show. I get it.